In the previous class, we were discussing about the concept of DPSK receiver. So in the previous class, we have not come to the block diagram of the receiver, but we have understood the basic mathematics required for developing the DPSK receiver. So today, we will just revise the yesterday's class, and finally, we will conclude with understanding the DPSK receiver. So the basic heart of the DPSK is differential encoding and the phase shift keying. All of us know, as per the definition of the DPSK, it involves two things: differential encoding and binary phase shift keying. Okay, differential encoding is done using the XNOR logic, which the concept have been explained in the following table. Now the first row is the binary data, and the second row is the differentially encoded data, and the third row is the transmitted phase based on the differential encoded data. This is how we were developing the DPSK transmitter. And while analyzing any DPSK signal, you were analyzing for two time intervals: the previous time interval and the current time interval, or in other words, the current time interval or and the next time interval. However you choose, you should choose two time intervals. Means if you want to transmit symbol one, say assume initially you will check what is the phase of the carrier, transmitted phase. If you want to transmit symbol one, you need not change the phase of the carrier. Okay. Unlike if you want to transmit symbol zero, you just check what is the phase of the carrier. Here in this example, before transmitting symbol zero, the phase was carrier of the carrier phase was pi. So therefore, for symbol zero transmission, you will advance the phase of the carrier by again pi radians, which would be a 0 degrees. So that is one thing. That is what you have understood in the previous class, in the previous thing, which has been pictorially represented. So symbol one transmission, there won't be change in the phase during the successive time intervals. So you can have another way of analyzing the symbol one transmission. What happens when symbol one gets transmitted? If you observe the waveform during the symbol one transmission, or whenever you want, when symbol one has been transmitted, the phase of the carriers over the two time intervals, that is 0 to TB and from TB to 2 TB, the phase remains same. You can also express like this. Okay. What was the basic logic? When you want to transmit symbol one, the initial phase of the carrier would be kept same. Okay. That is the basic concept. So how can you analyze this in the other fashion? Whenever symbol one has been transmitted, during the two time intervals, the phase remains same. That also could be understood. Similarly, when you try to understand symbol zero transmission, whenever zero has to be transmitted, for the initial phase, you are making a phase advancement of pi radians. Or if you observe the signal over two time intervals, and you observe any 180 degree phase shift, or if you observe any phase shift, then one can say that symbol zero has been transmitted. So what am I telling today is the after effect. When symbol zero has been transmitted, how can you visualize the waveform? When symbol one has been transmitted, how can you visualize the waveform? So I repeat, whenever symbol one has been transmitted, during the two time intervals, the phase of the carrier will remain same. When you transmit symbol zero, during the two time intervals, you are going to observe out of phase signals. That you please remember. Okay. So yesterday we have shown this mathematical analysis also. Basically, whenever you are transmitting during any time interval, if you observe during, if you take only this, during any time interval, so 0 to TB, you are having one signal, and during the other time interval, you are having the phase shifted signals. So therefore, you at any time instance, only two types of waveforms are possible. One is the in-phase waveform and another one is the out-of-phase waveforms. Only two waveforms are possible during the time instance. This holds good for symbol one transmission also. During the first time interval, the phase is zero. The phase is zero. And during the second time interval also, the phase is zero. So, okay, that is the case. Means both are in phase. During symbol zero transmission, what are you having? Symbol waveform with phase zero. And in the next time interval, a waveform with 180-degree phase shift. Those are the two possible cases. So therefore, I have written the two possible cases as follows. Okay. Now, here in the LHS, I have written x of t. What is x of t? X of t is the received signal. Remember, for every time interval, we are receiving one signal. But for our analysis, we need to analyze for two symbol intervals. Okay, so for every time interval, if you observe the waveform only, you can understand. For every time interval, I am going to get one signal. Okay, just observe 0 to TB, you are getting one signal. From TB to 2TB, you are getting another signal. That is what you are supposed to understand. So during any time interval, I will receive x of t. So that may be have the signal may contain zero phase. So that would be represented as root of 2 EB by TB cos 2 pi FCT. This theta is due to the channel effect. So once you simplify, you will express that in terms of in phase and quadrature phase components. The simplification is shown over here. Okay, so now what you have done, you have extracted the in phase and the quadrature phase components. What are in phase and quadrature phase? That component which is associated with cos 2 pi FCT is in phase component. That component which is associated with sin 2 pi FCT is the quadrature components. So now the signal x of t has been written in terms of in phase and quadrature phase components in the point form. So now what am I doing? I am observing the signal in the form of a point. Then if you are observing a signal in the form of a point, then what are the coordinates? How are you defining the coordinates? The in phase component will be coordinate number one and the quadrature phase component would be the coordinate two. Similarly, what is the other possibility? If you observe over here, you can get an out of phase signal. So out of phase signal means an inverted signal. So therefore, instead of adding pi over here, I am using the minus. 180-degree phase shift is nothing but put a minus sign. That would be the same effect. So now again, you use the cos of a plus b and write in this format, standard format, and extract the in phase and quadrature phase components. So two the signals are represented, two possible cases have been represented in the form of points. What are those points? The in phase value and the quadrature phase values. Okay, so signal carrying zero phase is having the positive coordinates, both coordinates are positive. Then for 180-degree phase shift, signal with 180-degree phase shift, the both coordinates are negative. So now if you plot this in a coordinate system, the signal with zero phase will occupy the first quadrant and signal with 180-degree phase shift will occupy the third quadrant as per the explanation given. As per the explanation given, this would occupy the third quadrant. That is obvious. So now that has been shown over here. Here, what is this is the possible signals what I am receiving at every time instant. For every TB instant, I am receiving one signal. So the signal may carry the zero phase or the signal may carry an out of phase or the signal may carry 180-degree or the signal may be out of phase. So what is the coordinate of this? A cos theta, A sin theta. And what is the coordinate of this one? Minus A cos theta, minus A sin theta. What does this represent? This represent the out of phase signal. And this represent the in phase signal. Signal represented in the form of a point. You know what is A? What is A? If you previously observe what is A, it is the amplitude of the carrier. And what is theta? It is the phase introduced by the channel that has been written. So now whatever the signal you are receiving, either it will fall over here or it may fall over here. These are the only two possible cases. Signal may fall in the first quadrant or signal may fall in the third quadrant. Only those two things are possible. So now we will analyze the receiver things. So what does the receiver will do? For every time instant, means for the first duration, second duration, third duration, fourth duration, so on and so forth, it is going to receive a signal. What is the nature of the signal? The nature of the signal may be in phase, or the nature of the signal may be out of phase. But all of you have, by this time, by repetitive explanation, all of you might have understood that to analyze any differential PSK, DPSK signal, we require two time instants. That all of you should remember, because how we have represented the signal, DPSK signal, okay, based on that, while analyzing, you should analyze for two time instants. Okay, so now what does the receiver will do? The receiver at every time instant, it will receive a signal, and that signal would be converted in the form of a point. So how a signal is converted in the form of a point, that you have seen over here. Signal, point, the coordinates are represented as xi and xq. Please don't forget that. Okay, xi and xq. So receiver will receive the signal, convert that into points as shown over here, and xi, xq. But here you have an additional subscript 0. What does this 0 means? The first instant of time, or the first time duration. Then during the second time duration, it will receive another signal that is also converted into form of the points, and the 1 over here, xi1, xq1. What does this 1 represent in this thing? This represents the signal received in the next time instance. So first time instant representation is 0. Second time instant, that is represented as 1. So that you are supposed to understand. Now, only two things are possible. Whatever the signals which we are getting, or in other words, the signal points which we are finding out, they may lie either in the same direction or they may lie in the opposite direction. Only two things are possible. You are having a signal, you plot a point. Again, you receive a signal, you plot another point. Those two points, where they may lie, both may lie in the first quadrant, which is one case, or they may lie in the opposite quadrants. Means that is what they are saying. So the points may map to same signal point or different ones. What do we mean by this? That we will see now. Okay. So now, how to understand this second concept? See here, what has been written? Issue to be resolved is whether these two points map to the same signal point or different ones. What does this sentence mean? That we will consider by taking an example. Okay. So all of us know what is xi and xq. What is the meaning of xi0, xq0, xi1 and xq1? What is xi0 and xq0? The signal point received at the first time instant. And what is xi1, xq1? Signal points which are received at the next time instant. That you need to understand. Now, what we will do is, we will directly get into the example only. What does the example say? Let us assume that symbol 1 is being transmitted. So this is the case. So what happens during symbol 1 transmission? Okay, you have transmitted symbol 1. This is the case. During the initial or the first time interval, what is the phase of the carrier? The phase of the carrier is 0. Okay. and during the second time interval also there is no phase change. Or in other words, what I can say is I am receiving two in phase signals. I repeat, whenever I transmit symbol one, what am I observing in this waveform? Whenever I transmit, I will receive signals at two different instances of time, and both signals are of same phase. Keep that in mind. Both signals are of same phase when during symbol one transmission. So according to the signal space diagram, if the signal are received in phase, then the signal will fall over here. Okay, that has been shown over here. See what happened. I received a signal during the first interval of time. That has been represented here as XI0 and XQ0, which is represented by the yellow circle. So after the next time interval, I received another signal. I converted that into a point, and that point was located at the same place. Okay, why? Because both the signals are having same phase. That is the thing. So now both signal points are lying in the same line. When that will happen? That will happen when you are transmitting symbol one. What is going to happen when you transmit symbol one? The signals which you are receiving during both time instants, are having same phase. If they are having same phase, then the signal points should lie at the same location. That is why it has been shown over here. So now by this time we know that any point could be treated as a vector. See, so this is the first signal point and this is the second signal point. So the first signal point could be treated as a vector and is represented as X0. 0 represents the first signal vector, and the second signal vector is represented as X1, whose values or whose elements are this. So now what I can say, these are the two signal points. One point is shown in the red color and another point is shown in the yellow color. We have plotted, and because both are in phase, they will occupy the first quadrant. Okay. So now mathematically, how to say both are lying in the first quadrant, or in terms of vectors, how can you say, if you observe both the signal vectors are pointing in the same direction here, only one line is represented in the form of a vector. The other vector is being coincided on the line. So therefore, both the vectors are pointing in the same direction. How to prove that mathematically, or what is the mathematical analysis, is this. You take the two signal vectors, perform the inner product. Inner product is take one vector, transpose it, and do matrix multiplication. X0 transpose X1. The answer will be greater than 0. Whenever the answer is greater than 0, then what can you mathematically say? Then that the two vectors will lie in the same line. So when they lie in the same line, which was the symbol which has been transmitted? Symbol 1. Because at the receiver, you cannot plot the graph and observe. What you can do? You can do calculations. So if the two signals, if they lie at the same location, then what would be the nature of the vectors? The nature of the vectors would be in the same direction. How would you mathematically prove that the two vectors are having the same direction? You will perform the inner product and you will get greater than 0. Okay. So now what can you conclude? When you transmit symbol 1, the two signals are having same phase, and hence the signal points lie in the same location, and hence the vectors will point in the same direction, or the inner products would be greater than 0. Okay, this is how you can conclude. Then if symbol 0 is being transmitted, so what would be the analysis? So symbol 0 would be transmitted means if you observe the basic waveform, one is carrying, the first waveform is carrying the zero phase and the second waveform is carrying the out of phase, or the second waveform is out of phase. Okay, with this knowledge, if you plot the two signals, the first signal is having zero phase, so therefore I have plotted in the first quadrant. The second signal is plotted over here because it is having a out of phase, or it is having 180 degree phase shift. Now points have been plotted and vectors have been analyzed. Anybody can say the two vectors are not pointing in the same direction, they are pointing approximately, or in other words exactly opposite points. Then mathematically what happens, if you take the inner product of these two vectors, it would be less than zero. So therefore what has happened, you have transmitted symbol zero. As a result, during two time instants you got two waveforms with opposite phase, one waveform having zero phase and another waveform having 180 degree phases. So therefore on plotting, the two points were opposite to each other, hence the vectors are pointing in different directions. Hence, the inner product would be less than zero. So therefore, what logic you are going to write in the receiver part, this is as follows. How can you? The value would be directly understood from the inner product. If the inner product is less than zero, then which symbol has been transmitted? Symbol zero. If the inner product is greater than zero, then what happens? Symbol one has to be, or symbol one is being transmitted. So therefore we can conclude that as follows. This, what does this term represent? This is inner product. If the inner product is greater than zero, what you are supposed to say? One has been transmitted. If the inner product, this summation is nothing but inner product. If the inner product, if it is less than zero, then what symbol is being transmitted? Zero. So based on this, you are developing the receiver. So what are you going to do at the receiver? You are computing the inner product. Just observe, how are you computing the inner product? See, there is a summation, okay, and there should be a multiplication. So what are the things which are multiplied? In phase component at the first time instant and in phase component at the second time instant, that should be multiplied first. Then okay, quadrature component at the first time instant and quadrature component at the second time instant, that should be multiplied and kept at a place. So if you do this, then you can easily design the receiver. So that is how the receiver has been designed. See over here, you are having the received signal x of t. How to get in phase component and quadrature phase component means, just observe, this is the first path. The first path after the integrator, you will get the in phase component. Okay, the second path after the integrator, you are getting the quadrature phase components. Okay, here, as I told, we are able to obtain the in phase component and the quadrature components by this arrangement. This much part of the block diagram will give you the in phase and the quadrature phase components. So at what is the equation? Equation is, first what you get? You get the in phase components at two different time instants. Yes. So what I will do? I will get the signal at one instant. I will get its in phase component. Okay. Then I will store that in phase component in this delay time block. Then after the next time interval, I will receive the signal and I will take the in phase component. Later, the current in phase component will be multiplied with the previously stored in phase component. So this is the job of the in phase components. Similarly, what you are supposed to do, you should take the quadrature phase components also. Quadrature phase component at the first time instant quadrature phase component at the next time instant. Quadrature phase component at the first instant and the next time instant. So how it has been shown in the receiver part? In the receiver part, it is shown over here. This will give you the quadrature component. Whenever for the first time you receive the signal, you calculate the quadrature component and store over here. During the next time interval, you calculate the quadrature component, and then you multiply the two as per the equation. So therefore, over here you are having the product of the in-phase components at two different instants, product of quadrature components at two different instants. So we are up till here, okay, product. And then finally, what you are supposed to have, the summation. So the summation is there. So what does this y will do? This y finally tells the inner product. Yes. So now what is the logic? If the inner product is less, this is less. If it is less than zero, then which symbol has been transmitted? Zero. Okay. So the same logic has been, y is nothing but the inner product. If it is less than zero, symbol zero has been transmitted. If the inner product is greater than zero, symbol one has been transmitted. So this is the complete block diagram. Okay. So by this, let me stop the session. So complete notes of the DPSK has been uploaded. You can go through the Google Classroom and you can download it. Today I will share the PPT also, complete PPT. Okay, you can refer that. So I am stopping the session.